Especially in that area, there are a lot of snakes, but
nice snakes.
Yeah, really nice and really friendly snakes. I haven't heard about snake bite somebody over there. One morning in the cave, it is quite cold in the winter. Normally in the cave, if outside it's hot, in the cave keep cool, it's cold inside. But if outside is cold, it keep warm inside. But on that day it's too cold, so in the cave it's cold also. So when I while I was sleeping, and I feel something here in my robe, near my robe.
Oh, it's like good warm.
Yeah. So when I feel like that, it's not just the rat, not just yes, because sometimes the rat or something comes in the cave, because it just nothing else. Only a few things. We have the growth, the mosquito net, but the growth sometimes is come too near us when something come. Actually, it is outside of the growth, but it's come to get some warmth from my body. It's quite long and quite big. So I feel like, oh, that's a big snake, because feeling like it touched through my body. I have two choices. One is I just leave it there and I walk somewhere else. But another choice, it might be better if I keep share the warmth with you. And so I decide to, okay, I'm sharing the warmth with you until morning time, and that's the time that I have to go for arms round. Normally when we get up, we need to tidy the goat back. But at that time, I decide to put the goat down and cover it like a blanket, and I slowly leave it. All day, that day, they're still there. It's still there. Big python.
Python. But what about the king cobra outside when it's raining?
Yeah. King cobra is one day when my mother was there with me, she lived near the lake, at her house, a small house near the lake. He sat and he saw it rain, and he saw that something like try to dive in the water, but it's too long and too big, so it can't do only its head, its tail still come and try to. She said, "Oh, it's playing with the rain." it's wonderful. And up the day later, when we go to the salon for the evening chanting, when we finish evening chanting, and we did the meditation, and I heard the sound on the wooden salon. When we pay metta and we share the blessing, loving kindness, and share the universal well-being to all beings, and when we bow, closing homage, and I turn back for the young monks to bow, and I saw on the sala, but it's wooden, so it's difficult for her to move. She just something like that. So the best thing to do is just go to say hello and to see if I can help. And then somebody, the villagers came at that time to be, the teacher and the villagers came. She's a young teacher, a new teacher, with camera, so she took photograph. And then when we walk down the sala, I saw under the stair, her egg there.
Oh.
55. What we can do is keep there, keep there, and after that just disappear. And nobody heard about the king cobra by anyone.
Only when you walked outside from the cave with the umbrella.
Yeah. Yes. Also, one day it's nearly dark. I walked out from the cave with umbrella because it rained. But to walk through the bamboo, many bamboo trees, it's difficult to do this. So I just
fold
and walk. And when I walk at the bamboo tree, because it's heavy upright, so I need to do something like that, and it's the king cobra came along. when I do something like that, it's something like it scare it. It's quite that short, but it's higher than me, a lot higher. So what I can do is just stay a bit firm and to see, because I already disturb it. So when it like this, so I slowly the umbrella, I think it's, it may scare off the umbrella because it's bigger than it. And it's just like this and turn away.
It didn't bite?
Something like...
You detected it?
Yeah. But boop. And it's scared of that.
I think when we talk about the Buddha Metta project, maybe we don't